gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today, a day before we begin the 9-day preparation for the solemnity of the Immaculate Conception, we implore the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of all graces, that this period of preparation may be graces, may be days of grace. We also run to her for all our personal needs and for the needs of our country. Let us ask the Blessed Virgin Mary that our country will enjoy political peace and progress. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, our God, in your eternal wisdom and love, you chose the Blessed Virgin Mary to be the mother of the author of all grace, and as his companion in bringing about the mystery of our redemption. Grant that she may obtain for us graces in abundance, and lead us at last to the harbor of eternal salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw an angel come down from heaven, holding in his hand the key to the abyss and a heavy chain. He seized the dragon, the ancient serpent, which is the devil or Satan, and tied it up for 1,000 years and threw it into the abyss, which he locked over it and sealed, so that it could no longer lead the nations astray until the 1,000 years are completed. After this, it is to be released for a short time. Then I saw the thrones. Those who sat on them were entrusted with judgment. I also saw the souls of those who had been beheaded for their witness to Jesus and for the word of God, and who had not worshipped the beast or its image, nor had accepted its mark on their foreheads or hands. They came to life, and they reigned with Christ for 1,000 years. Next, I saw a large white throne and the one who was sitting on it. The earth and the sky fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. I saw the dead, the great and the lowly, standing before the throne, and scrolls were opened. Then another scroll was opened, the book of life. The dead were judged according to their deeds, by what was written in the scrolls. The sea gave up its dead. Then death and Hades gave up their dead. All the dead were judged according to their deeds. Then death and Hades were thrown into the pool of fire. This pool of fire is the second death. Anyone whose name was not found written in the book of life was thrown into the pool of fire. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here God lives among his people.
Here God lives among his people.
My soul yearns and pines for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God.
Here God lives among his people.
Even the sparrow finds a home, and the swallow a nest, in which she puts her young. Your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
Here God lives among his people.
Blessed are they who dwell in your house. Continually they praise you. Bless the man whose strength you are. They go from strength to strength.
Here God lives among his people. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples a parable. Consider the fig tree and all the other trees. When their buds burst open, you see for yourselves and know that summer is now near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Amen, I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear fellow community members of the Manila Cathedral, and even those who are following us online. Today, we unveil the new design of the background design of the image of Our Lady here at the sanctuary. This is a design of rays with stars and beautifully crafted by Vitra Artus, Laguna, owned and managed by a friend, Robert Cruz. And this design will remain until February 2, and we will put this design every fiesta. And you can see in the monitor, the words sub tuum presidium confugimus. And yun, no? Translated, we fly to thy patronage. We fly to thy patronage. And this Latin phrase is part of an ancient Marian prayer. The complete text of which in English is this: We fly to thy patronage, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. This is the earliest Marian prayer believed to be written in the 3rd century, around 270. And here, we can already see that the early Christians, as early as 270 or 3rd century, or even earlier, no, already look at the Blessed Mother as their refuge. Pag may problema, takbo kay Maria. Pag may kailangan, lapit sa nanay. And this is giving us an assurance, no, that Mary, being a true and beloved mother, will always assist her children in their need. That is an assurance that should give us strength as we face the challenges of life. So many times we have so many needs, and where do we go, or where we should go to help us and pray for us? The Blessed Mary, the Blessed Mother. We fly to your patronage, O Virgin Mother of God. And even in the Gospel, that is the same assurance being given to us by the Lord. You remember, in the past days, what we hear in the Gospel are troubling, di ba? Sky falling, stars falling from the sky. There will be destructions. And even if they are not happening yet, still, we are already experiencing so many challenges in life. Mabigat na karamdaman, nawalan ng trabaho, problema sa mag-asawa, adik na anak. All of these things stress us. But in the Gospel, Jesus also is giving us an assurance. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. All these things may happen, but don't worry, I will not leave you. Parang sinasabi sa atin ni Jesus, huwag ka mag-alala, sagot kita. Sagot kita. And there is also the responsorial psalm. Here, God lives among His people. So you have Mary, you have Jesus, you have God assuring us of their help, of their intercession, of their love. Eh ano pa naman ang ikatatakot natin? Kung kakampi mo na ang Diyos, kung kakampi mo na si Jesus, kung kasama mo na si Maria, what is there to be afraid of? My dear sisters and brothers, today, the Blessed Mother and Jesus give us an assurance. We will take care of you. Amen.
Please stand.
The Lord Jesus has called us to watch for the day of His return. Let us come to the Father in prayer, watching and waiting for His return. To every petition, our response would be, Lord of history, sustain us.
Lord of history, sustain us.
That the church may respond to the call for conversion and renewal, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of history, sustain us.
That people of goodwill may work together to put an end to war and hatred, oppression and injustice, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of history, sustain us.
That we may increase our awareness of the presence of Christ among the poor and the suffering people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of history, sustain us.
That the sick may be given strength and hope, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of history, sustain us.
That our friends and relatives who have died may experience everlasting joy in the company of Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord of history, sustain us.
Almighty God, listen to our prayers. Open our eyes to your presence all around us. Make us closer to you each day. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, receive our offering of peace and praise on this memorial of the Virgin Mary in glory. By the power of the Holy Spirit, make what we present the sacrament of our redemption, so that what Christ, our mediator, has established as the means of our reconciliation with you may become for us the source of grace and the enduring fountain of eternal salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. It is for truly God and truly human, he was chosen by you as the one mediator between you and the human family, always living to make intercession for us. In your wisdom and goodness, the Blessed Virgin Mary, the mother and companion of the Redeemer, was to have a maternal role in the Church of intercession and pardon, of prayer and grace, of reconciliation and peace. The love that she bestows as a mother is entirely the gift of Christ, the one mediator, from whom alone she receives her power. Her children, in their trials and fears, turn with confidence to the Blessed Virgin, calling to her as Mother of Mercy and Handmaid of Grace. In our joy, we sing to your glory with all the choirs of angels.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Refresh, Lord God, at the fountain of salvation, we pray that by the power of this sacrament and through the prayers of the Blessed Virgin, we may be more closely united to Christ the Mediator and ever more faithfully enter into the mystery of redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I already mentioned earlier during my homily that Tomorrow will be the beginning or the first day of our 9-day novena in honor of Our Lady Immaculately Conceived. So on Saturdays, the Mass will be at 7:30 in the morning. On Sunday, the novena Mass will be at 10 in the morning. And from Monday to Friday, the novena Mass will be at 12:10. We invited the Jubilarians this year, Silver and 48, to preside over the Eucharistic celebration. I hope we will be seeing you during these coming days. The schedule of the solemnity, schedule of Masses on the Solemnity of the Immaculate Conception on December 9, not 8, December 9 will be 7:30 in the morning, 12:10 in the afternoon, and 6 p.m. Because so far there is no declaration from the government that December 9 will be a holiday. So we will treat this as an ordinary schedule of the Mass. So 7:30, 12:10, and 6 p.m. And you may be wondering, why is there a big stage in front of you? There will be a concert tonight at 7 p.m. presented by the Philippine Suzuki Youth Orchestra. The composition of the orchestra is as young as 9 years old and as old as, I think, 21. No? So they will be presenting a pre-Christmas concert, Gaudete, Windows to Christmas. So there are tickets available at the parish office, I think at 650 pesos. So para na yun sa senior citizen, may discount na yun. Para na lang kayo nanood ng sine ng Hello Love Again at kumain pagkatapos, no? Okay, so I hope we will see you also tonight. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, Ina, Ina.